you're playing for Iowa, and maybe how this compares a little bit to 2008 and the differences you've seen 4 years later.
Okay, are we live, Steve, at this time?
Yes, we're live. Dr. Paul, can you tell us how this compares to maybe 4 years ago?
Well, from my viewpoint, it's dramatically different. It's different for the campaign, but I think it's different for the country. The country is quite a bit concerned about those issues that I've been talking about for a long time, and they were just becoming noticeable, in 2007, 2008. So the dramatic difference occurred when the housing bubble burst, and many in this country came to realize that there truly was a financial bubble, and we've been suffering the consequence ever since. So now many people who thought that we were alarmists before now are saying, well, maybe we should have listened to you. So it's much easier to get volunteers, much easier to get interest, much easier to raise money. And our numbers are growing, and even the public perception is quite different. Perception, in the media, and it takes a bit to get a fair treatment in the media when you want to, talk about the Constitution and really limiting government. So I see it dramatically different. I'm very, very pleased that things are going well. I just wish Washington would do a little bit better, because so far we haven't seen any real good changes in Washington.
Yeah, I mean, it certainly seems like there's a different dynamic now, as far as the welcoming crack we've got from people in the Republican parties, people who are, coming out to vote, and people who are independents. And it definitely seems like, the dynamic has shifted your way. Could you speak a little bit about that? I mean, do you feel like when you talk to people, they say, yeah, 3-4 years ago, I thought this way, but now, this is how I'm feeling? Or are you really kind of got me energized?
Yeah, I noticed it gradual, but for quite a few years, but it was dramatic here in the last 4 years. I actually thought that maybe after the last campaign was over, that things would settle down and they wouldn't pay much attention to what we were talking about. But surprisingly enough to me, the momentum kept growing, and more people joined us. Even in my own congressional district, I remember taking some of these strong stands, which had to challenge President Bush, because he was from Texas and always remained very popular. But so many of his positions, whether it was doubling the size of the Department of Education, or having another medical program, prescription drug programs, or the wars that we were involved, the average person in Texas, especially Republican conservatives, were very uncomfortable. I think they were more confused. But over the years, they gradually came to realize that we were going in the wrong direction, and we were going the same way that many of the liberal Democrats were taking us. But that has accelerated here, in the last 3 years. And even today, I think whether I'm traveling all through Iowa or New Hampshire, where I'm spending most of my time, the numbers that are coming out are really pleasing us and surprising us. I think each trip we make up into Iowa, we're very pleased with the numbers of people that that come out, and they're new people too. It's not, it's always nice to talk to the choir, and we always please, but we need to talk to more, and I think that's what's happening. But we still have a long way to go to reach the total number of people that we need.
Yeah, absolutely. If you're just joining the call, we're here with Congressman Ron Paul running for president, and Iowa State Chairman Drew Ivers. If you'd like to get a ticket for the Iowa straw poll in Ames on August 13th, please press 7 right now, and you'll be routed to a live staffer working in the office right now. Dr. Paul, as far as the dynamic you've seen in the debates, obviously you gained a lot of national attention when you kind of had that back and forth with Rudy Giuliani. Do you get a sense from people now that they respect you a little bit more? No one, has come out yet in the debate and directly attacked you. In fact, they're kind of saying the same thing that you've been saying for maybe 3 or 4 years just as president, and for many, many years as an individual. What kind of interaction do you have with people on the debates with the candidates?
Well, in the debates 4 years ago, they would use my name and challenge me like Giuliani did, but others did it too, and a lot of times it was laughing or snickering, and then sometimes we'd even get boos. And people said, did that bother you? I thought nobody likes that, but I always understood it. But the last, we've had two debates already, and they do acknowledge me now, but they're not acknowledging it sometime, in a very polite manner, or they'll just acknowledge that the positions that they're holding have sort of changed, like, maybe we should start bringing these troops home, and, you know, we are really in a mess. Maybe we ought to do this. And so I think there's no doubt there's a difference. And when you think about in the in-between years from 08 up until now, major media, especially, you know, Fox, which wasn't always going out of their way to help me, they've been very interested in having me on their programs and talking about the economy. And even so, in recent months, they're actually allowing me to talk a little bit about foreign policy as well.
Excellent, excellent. We're on the call right now with Dr. Ron Paul, running for president, and Drew Ivers, Iowa campaign chairman. We're talking about the campaign here in Iowa, specifically the Ames Straw Poll on August 13th, which is a Saturday. If you'd like to get a ticket for the Iowa Straw Poll, we're giving tickets to supporters for a greatly discounted rate. Please press 7 on your phone right now. You'll be routed to a live staff member who can help you out, and then you'll get put right back in the call. Dr. Paul, the last question before we get started, regarding the campaign trail in Iowa and New Hampshire, as far as the toll that a presidential race takes on someone, you've been able to handle it pretty well. Not only are you a sitting congressman, but you're running for president. How would you say that you best deal with that? Would you say that it has a lot to do with just preparation beforehand? Are you used to it now because you've done it 4 years prior? How can you kind of get through the day-to-day grind of it?
Well, I think the biggest thing that gives me the energy to do it is my determination and my being convinced that what we're doing is very, very important. And a lot of people think, well, you know, Ron Paul's doing this and that. And it really isn't. It's just me delivering a message that somebody else has devised over the years, and I'm delivering this message, but I'm really enthusiastic. And if you're enthusiastic like that mentally, you can get some physical enthusiasm too. But I also am encouraged by the many people that come out and support me, and I've said many times that this is especially true in a younger generation. And, you know, recently I got a real boost and a lot more enthusiasm came into the campaign when we found out that we had much more than twice as many donations from active military duties than all the other candidates put together, and more than even the president has had. So these things all are very helpful. I think there's a bit of a physical endurance that you need as well, and both as an individual that did a lot of athletics as well as understanding medicine and some good practical health habits, I'm pretty determined to stay in good condition. So it's not even some of these very, very busy days that are campaigning that I don't get my exercise in. And exercise is very important to me, both mentally and physically.
Excellent. Well, we're on the call this evening with Dr. Ron Paul, a presidential candidate, and Drew Ivers, Iowa campaign chairman. And as we start, just want to remind everyone that if you have not yet reserved your ticket for the Iowa Straw Poll, it really is imperative. It's a big determining factor in determining the strength of early campaigns. If you want, you can press 7 on your phone right now. You'll be routed to a live staffer who can take care of that for you and get that ticket, and then you'll put you right back in the call, and you can listen to Dr. Paul and Drew. I'd like to introduce Drew Ivers. Drew Ivers is the Iowa campaign chairman here in Iowa, and he's been involved in a number of campaigns over the years, and so far he's successfully helped Dr. Paul establish a very solid presence here in Iowa, not only over the last 3 years, but certainly going forward. So I'll let Drew Ivers speak a little bit on the Iowa Straw Poll, and then he will introduce Dr. Paul. Drew?
Yeah, thank you, Steve, for setting this up and give us all opportunity to listen and maybe catch the spirit of making history here in Iowa. And as all of you know, just 5 days ago, we had a very successful Ready, Aims, Fire money bomb, over a $500,000, that was dedicated to our Iowa Straw Poll. Which, by the way, is just 19 days from tomorrow. And nearly all that money came from hardworking folks outside of Iowa who are looking to us here in Iowa to do what they cannot do, and that is to vote for Ron Paul on August 13th, which is, again, just a few days from now. So these freedom-loving friends of ours, I think, have high expectations and confidence that we want Ron Paul supporters in Iowa can deliver the votes necessary to do well in Ames and show the country that Ron Paul is, in my opinion, the only candidate with the right message and character to revive our republic. So I challenge all of us Iowans to resolve within ourselves, each individually, to seize this historic opportunity. So starting tomorrow, to start asking even our non-political friends, those who tolerate politics but aren't necessarily activists, to ask them as a personal favor to come to Ames and vote for Ron Paul, and tell them that other supporters will cover the cost of their tickets. So if they just come and vote anytime between 10 a.m. and 4 p.m., we'll make sure that we can take care of the details and accommodate their presence. But the main thing, of course, is that they have the opportunity to participate in making history. And so even though we've been visiting with Ron, a little bit of an intro that I really don't need to make, but one of the things I like to talk about Ron Paul is that he is an authentic, in my opinion, and I think a lot of people agree with me, modern-day statesman. And frankly, he's in a category by himself with an amazing record spanning over 30 years of legislating to shrink government. And really no other candidate comes close to his standard of actually doing what he says he will do. So I'm pleased to be a part of a campaign of a 12-term winning statesman, and I believe the only candidate who can beat Obama in the general election, and that is, of course, our own Ron Paul.
Ron Paul, thank you for joining us tonight.
Okay. Well, Drew, thank you very much, and I'll just give a little update about the campaign. You know, the one thing that comes up, I think it comes up every time an election year comes around, and some candidates, too, they question, why should Ames be important? Why should Iowa be important? Why should New Hampshire be important? Why should these small states, you know, be so significant? Well, you know, the thing that I would dread and probably wouldn't be able to even compete is if the country went to do national attention. So you get big bang for the bucks if you can do well there, and if you can win it, boy, I'll tell you, it can give you a lot of momentum. So I just think it's a wonderful opportunity to show the enthusiasm for the freedom movement, and it's so necessary. That's the reason I stay in this. It's so utterly necessary for us to do something other than the same old things of spending and borrowing and printing money and regulating and taxing people. And I don't think this is just Obama, you know, he's bad. He's made it worse. But this has been going on a long time. I mean, we shifted gears all the way back to Woodrow Wilson. I mean, that's when the income tax came and the Federal Reserve came in, the foreign policy changed. So then we lived, you know, off our prosperity to the point where finally we had to live off borrowing. And now the borrowing is getting more difficult, and the debt is the big issue. The debt has, you know, just brought us to a halt. So we have to really present our case for limited government. Fortunately for us who believe in limited government, we can also say, you know, why don't we obey the Constitution? So we're on the side of the Constitution. We're on the side of American tradition. We're on the side of good economic policy. So our job is to make sure the people get that message so they can support us.
Yeah. If you're just joining us, we're on with Congressman Ron Paul at our Teletown Hall this evening. We're discussing the Iowa campaign for president. Dr. Paul is running for president in Iowa and obviously throughout the country as well. The big push we're making is for the Iowa straw poll in Ames on Saturday, August 13th. Dr. Paul shared a little bit about how important that is. If you do not yet have your ticket, please press 7 on your phone right now. You'll be connected to a live staff member in our Iowa office who can reserve that ticket for you, and then they'll send you right back to the call to hear Dr. Paul speak. We're connecting with literally thousands of people across Iowa, and it is vitally important, as Dr. Paul explained, that we have a good showing in the Iowa straw poll. Press 7 Right now, you'll be connected to a live staff member who can reserve that ticket for you, and then they'll shoot you right back to the call. Dr. Paul, as we push forward a little more, one of the things that we've tried to do in Iowa is kind of build the backbone or build the structure of the campaign. We've had county coordinators, county co-chairmen, people who can, you know, understand how Iowa operates and really build the campaign structure just like a regular campaign. How important do you think it is that we have that structure? And then in addition to, you know, the young people on college campuses and you know, social media and things like that, that we have solid people willing to help and willing to volunteer.
Well, if you don't have it, you don't have a real campaign. And I have to admit that I was more hopeful 4 years ago, but we didn't have the organization that we have now. And it continues to build, so we're way ahead. But also, Drew and others have told me, they keep tabs on exactly what I'm doing, and they tell me that I've been in Iowa many times more than I was the entire campaign last time. So I know the importance of getting in there and talking to people, meeting. You know, I've agreed to go and meet the very, very many of these small groups of people like. But the staff has told me that they're so pleased because the very, very small groups I agree to meet with aren't very, very small. We get nice numbers out, so they've been impressed, and that just helps us. It helps us build this momentum, and I've been very impressed with the numbers in the organization, you know, by each county, and this to me is fantastic. So the staff is doing a great job out there.
Yeah. And if you're just joining us, we're on the call with Ron Paul. We're hosting a Teletown Hall. We're talking about the Iowa Straw Poll in Ames on Saturday, August 13th. If you have not yet reserved your ticket, you can press 7 on your phone right now, and you'll be routed to a live staff member who can reserve that ticket for you, and they'll put you right back in the call. I know we have a number, Dr. Paul, a number of our county coordinators on the line, and we actually have a contest going for county coordinators specifically to recruit people. Basically, for those county coordinators who can recruit at least 5 people, we have a special signed edition of Liberty Defined that you'll sign for them. If you recruit only 5 people, that's for everyone who grabs their friends, grab their neighbors, anything like that. All you would need to do when you get your ticket this evening is tell the staff member who's answering that you want to use your name as the promo code, or we can, you know, put that in for you later. That's not a problem. And for the top 5 recruiters in the entire state, we'll have tickets to the Iowa straw poll or Iowa debate 2 nights prior. Those tickets are actually sold out. There's no other tickets available for individuals, but the campaign has accumulated a few of them, and we're willing to give those to the top 5 recruiters in the state. So if you have friends, you have family, you have neighbors, you know they're going to come out and support Ron Paul, press 7 on your phone right now. You'll be routed to a live staff member. And just tell them, hey, you know, I want to recruit people. I have some friends. I have some family. You know, I want to get those prizes. So those are some incentives for people who can recruit a little bit more. And Dr. Paul, you mentioned the close, you know, proximity of the vote. You mentioned that there was a straw poll in Louisiana a couple of years back where it was literally one vote made the difference. And for those people who maybe be a little bit more involved in the Iowa straw poll and a little bit older, they'll remember that not too long ago, you know, there was actually a tie in the Iowa straw poll. There was actually literally a tie in the Iowa straw poll. So if you're on this call and you don't think your vote makes a difference, and we have literally thousands of people we've reached out to in Iowa, I can tell you right now, if everyone on this call came out and supported Ron Paul, he would win this straw poll overwhelmingly. And we want to have a good showing in Iowa. We really want to have Dr. Paul be competitive. So if you think your vote doesn't matter, if you think you support Ron Paul but you don't want to make the trip to Ames, I can tell you it is vitally important. You know, the amount of good press that we can get from this and the amount of support that Ron Paul can continue is absolutely vital. So the Iowa straw poll is in Ames. It's on August 13th, which is a Saturday. You can press 7 to be routed to a live staff member who can reserve that ticket for you, and they'll put you right back in the call as well. Dr. Paul, as we kind of end here and follow up with some final words, the amount of work that you've put in, obviously, you know, it goes without saying that you're a sitting congressman, you're still able to make your votes, and you're still able to, campaign around the state. You know, you're going to be here in Iowa tomorrow, you're going to be in Ames, and you're going to be in Cedar Rapids. We have a lot of events that you've been here literally every week. How do you think that that plays with other campaigns? I know there's a lot of campaigns that aren't here even that often. How do you feel that people really get a sense of your message? Do you feel like it's a constant every time you're here, you feel positive feedback?
Yes, and as the time has gone on, I meet more people that weren't necessarily involved 3 or 4 years ago. For a while, you know, it was sort of the same people over and over again, but now it's the new people coming in. It's the people who were sort of mainstream. Somebody kidded me the other day that they said, "Ron Paul, looks like you're going mainstream." And I said, "Well, maybe the country is moving in my direction and we're all going to be mainstream." So, however, our numbers are growing. But I want to, as we close, Steve, I want to compliment you for your hard work and the staff out there, and certainly Drew has done a great job, and all the supporters have been around for so long. That is just great. But we see this as being very important. One thing I've done over the years, whether it's my congressional races or whatever I've done, I have always been reluctant to put any pressure on my family because, you know, I just didn't feel like it. I wasn't going to say, do this. So I was always very reluctant to, but they were always quite willing to do it, and they were very much involved. My wife and the kids were involved in all the campaigns. But they're very interested in Ames, and they're getting excited. They think it's going to go well, and they want to encourage everybody. So they've gone out and rented a bus, and there's somewhere between 20 and 25 members of my family that will be driving up there, I guess, on Wednesday of that week to be there to encourage the voters. But I want to thank everybody, those of you who are listening, encourage you to come out and just keep working hard because we have a couple weeks to go.
Yeah, now, Dr. Paul, as we close, you mentioned your family is taking a bus. If you've not yet gotten your ticket to the Ames Straw Poll on August 13th, in addition to all of, you know, the food, entertainment, ability to vote for Ron Paul, we've got custom merchandise. The campaign is offering bus transportation directly from your county to Ames and back at no additional cost. So literally for $10, it includes everything. It includes a bus ride to Ames and back, an air-conditioned bus. It includes free food, it includes family entertainment, it includes free merchandise, it includes the ability to have full access to the fair, and includes, most importantly, the ability to vote for Ron Paul. So again, for the thousands of people that are on this call this evening, we've got live staff members working on a Sunday night specifically to help you out. Press 7 on your phone right now. You'll be routed to a live staff member. They can reserve that ticket for you. They can give you information on the bus. They can give you information on the ticket itself. And for those who are county coordinators or want to recruit more people, if you can recruit 5 friends and send them to our way, we have a free Ron Paul signed book, Liberty Defined. And if you can recruit so many that you're the top 5 recruiters in the state, we'll have a debate ticket for you to the Thursday night debate, where I can assure you Ron Paul will easily outwit his opponents without question. Again, press 7. Right now, you'll be routed to a live caller or a live staff member who can take that call for you, and they'll help you out. They'll get you that ticket. It's $10. It's all-inclusive. You get a bus ride from your county to Ames and back. You really cannot beat that. And if you're thinking, well, you know, I want to support Ron Paul, but I don't know if I want to go that far, you're going to be on a bus with Ron Paul supporters. You know, we really have a chance to make history, literally make history. If Ron Paul, you know, were to come up just short, you don't want to be that person who sat at home and said, "Wow, I really could have made a difference." You know, we want you to do that. We want you to come. Press 7 right now on your phone. Like I said, bus transportation, merchandise, food, family entertainment, it's all included. A staff member will help you out right here. We'll get you that information. And you really have a chance to make history. And that's not something we should take lightly. Drew, I have a question for you. Drew Ivers, our Iowa campaign chairman, is on the call as well. Could you just speak for a quick second, and then I want Dr. Paul to expound upon it, the difference that you see from the support in 2007 to now and how that's grown?
Well, it's thank you for that question. That's a great question because it is dramatic. I remember in June of 2007, the polls in Iowa had Ron Paul's name recognition really close to zero. And so we came in with an unknown candidate in Iowa in June of 2007, and by January the 3rd, just a few months later, we had a triple tie for third place. As many of our listeners recall, Huckabee won that thing by a pretty big margin and then a pretty big spread, and Romney came in second. And then there was a 12-point gap, and we had Ron Paul, John McCain, and Fred Thompson with a close triple tie. And so we moved that quickly with a very small beginning, and actually, like I said, a no-name beginning. So that is a testimony to the message and the messenger. And to grow that rapidly tells me, from the political experience I've had over the years, that people are listening. You can't move that quickly. And so now, comparing that to this year, now we have a very well-known candidate with a message that has been proven to be effective, and we're growing on top of that. I'm pretty optimistic that there is a great awakening politically going on in this country. And with the economic stress that we're all experiencing, it's a testimony of what Congressman Paul has been experiencing and been witnessing to others in terms of the political impact of the failed policies that we've had, both foreign and domestic.
Yeah, and if again, as we kind of close the call, we want to thank all of our Iowa residents for being on the call. Dr. Paul, Drew Rivers, just a couple more minutes as we close up. If you haven't got it yet, like I said, if you press 7 on your phone right now, you can be routed to a live staff member who's literally sitting in our office on a Sunday night, specifically just to help you get this ticket. A $10 ticket, you're able to reserve by pressing 7 on your phone right now. You'll get a full day's pass to the event, food, transportation, special campaign merchandise you will not get anywhere else, and a bus ticket, bus transportation on an air-conditioned bus directly from your county to Ames and back that evening at no additional cost, absolutely free or absolutely included. Again, if you press 7 on your phone right now, you'll be routed to a live staff member who can help you out with that. Please do not think that your vote does not matter. Like I said, if everyone on this call right now were to get that ticket, or even probably half of the people on this call were to get that ticket, Dr. Paul would really shock a lot of people at the straw poll. So if you press 7 on your phone right now, please press 7. You'll be routed to a live staff member. They'll help you out. They'll get you that ticket. Like I said, an air-conditioned bus, free food, family entertainment, the Ron Paul tent. We're going to have a lot of fun, but we really can't do it if we don't have the support. And luckily for us, we have the grassroots supporters and the people who are genuinely dedicated to the cause that other campaigns simply do not have. Other campaigns, you know, they have to buy their way through, you know, through X, Y, and Z, and they have to do things, and they have to compromise their principles. And Dr. Paul has never compromised his principles, as long as I've known him, and certainly much longer than that in the years that he's been in Congress. So your vote really does make a difference, and we're really asking everyone to come out and support Ron Paul. You know, he's done so much for us. Let's help him out here. Please press 7 on your phone right now. You'll be allotted to a live staff member in the office on a Sunday night trying to help you out. We've got a $10 ticket to the straw poll. It includes everything you need, bus transportation, food, entertainment, music, all of that. We're going to close up the call this evening. I'd like to thank everyone for being on the call. I'd like to thank Drew Ivers, our Iowa campaign chairman, and Ron Paul. We'll close this up. Drew, before we end, could you speak just for a minute on the importance of the straw poll, and then I'll ask you to turn it over to Dr. Paul. And Dr. Paul, if you can make a last personal pitch to the supporters on this call. Okay. Like I said, again, if you press 7 right now, you'll be routed to a live staff member who will help you out in our office, get you that ticket. And Drew, could you speak a little to that?
Yes, I can, Steve. Thank you. Yeah, I would like to challenge us all a little bit with what we're obviously up to here, and that is doing very, very well at the upcoming opportunity with a little bit of history. And, you know, it was on a Wednesday morning in April the 19th of 1775 that about 70 American Minutemen and about 700 British soldiers met at Lexington. And, you know, a shot rang out, heard round the world, and the first birth pangs of our freedom left 8 Americans dead and 10 wounded. By the way, no British casualties. Well, in comparison to the world events that we're used to today, this seems quite small and insignificant and maybe barely a beginning, but we all know the rest of the story. And now, today here in Iowa, the Ames straw polls, to many, seems quite small and insignificant. And frankly, 99% plus of the Iowans will not attend unless you get them there. And if you do that, get them there, and allow the rest, then we will be able to write the rest of this story, which indeed can make history. So for our children's sake and for those around the country who are counting on us here in Iowa, let's not let this opportunity escape our grasp. And I believe that with it, and we have within our power, as Steve has said and we have reiterated, to actually make history. So bring your friends to Ames. Do not let time or travel or cost get in the way. We just need from you committed names on a list, and we will do the rest. So for details, go to our website, iowaforronpaul.com, and get the details. And one last thing, and Steve already mentioned it, I'll do it one more time. Tomorrow morning, 9:30, Ames, Iowa, Congressman Paul will be sharing his vision of prosperity and peace and restoration of our republic. And then at noon, at Cedar Rapids. So again, for details, go to the website, Ron Paul, iowaforronpaul.com, and get that information. So with that, Dr. Paul, you get the last word. We are appealing for people to seize the opportunity that I believe fate has laid in their hands, to grasp it, and even though the significance may not appear apparent to us at this moment, I do believe it is upon us. So,
okay.
Your final comments, if you would.
Yeah. And thank you. I think you've stated it very well. And I think the important thing about the Ames straw vote is that legally it has no meaning because it's a straw vote. But when you compare the importance of it, because not everybody votes, a small percentage are coming out, its value is much greater than it might seem because it's a nationally known straw vote. So it's very, very important. And all I can say is thank everybody who's listened in. Hope we have convinced you to come out. Maybe I'll see some of you tomorrow. But it's something I have been working on for many, many years to promote this cause. And it's delightful to know that the momentum is building. And I think we're going to surprise a lot of people.
Yeah, absolutely. Thank you again, Drew, our Iowa campaign chairman. Thank you, Ron Paul, Congressman Ron Paul, presidential candidate, for being on.